Now we drop down to the river's edge, which is ahead of us. We'll walk around this terraced area near the road. Beyond us is the tower for Vilnius Castle Hill that we'll visit tomorrow, probably on the walking tour. And somewhere between here and there is the area called Užupis. Our first view of this peaceful river that winds through Vilnius and wraps around the area we're going to. And in the background, beyond the castle mount, are new skyscrapers heralding the emergence of Lithuania under the auspices of the UN, NATO, and the United States. Off the street now, down at the river's level, near its side. Very pretty bucolic area. How lovely it would be to live in one of those homes, I think, or someplace similar to this, if you lived in Vilnius. To quote one of my old cartoons, wrong again, it's not the river. People sunbathing. Behind me, some folks are fishing in this, what looks like a slough, but perhaps it works. Rika and Shazam, there be a bridge, and this street lined with tour buses. Yuck! Peaceful look upstream across this old iron bridge. Of course, the tradition of locks on bridges and elsewhere to symbolize eternal love. I always like to look for the combination locks if there are. Heavy-duty lock. Someone had something important they wanted to say. This is probably bought from a shop specifically for this purpose, engraved with their names. If the three locks on the chain symbolize friendship amongst couples. I look downstream, another bridge down there, perhaps just a pedestrian bridge. But what a tranquil place to live here. This is considered to be the old town. Wonder why they're cleaning off. Wonder if they're removing those vines. Now it looks like they're clean between. Where we're going is usually considered to be the ratty center of artists, drunks, druggers, and so forth. But they may be, like so often is the case, elevating themselves. Or not themselves, but the area. As it becomes chic for the wealthier to live here. We search for ambience, flavor, church. Interesting things about this area of Vilnius is it has declared itself an autonomous region, has its own mayor, etc., etc., and its own set of laws within a constitution. That constitution memorialized here in different languages. So we'll look for the English. This is in English for the Uspio Republica, or the Republic of Uspius. I'll go through the constitution a bit, looking at some of the high points. Everyone has the right to live by the river Vilnius. And as the river has the right to flow by everyone. Everyone has the right to hot water, heating in winter, and a tiled roof. Everyone has a right to die, but not the obligation. Everyone has the right to be undistinguished and unknown, to be idle, to take care of the cat. As everyone has the right to be unaware of their duties. Everyone has the right to be in doubt, but like life, to right to die, this is not an obligation. No one has the right to violence. Everyone may share what they possess. No one can share what they do not possess. No one has the right to make another person guilty. Everyone has the right to have no rights. Is that anarchy? Everyone has the right to not be afraid. Last one, do not surrender. To the first main intersection. We'll obviously just continue to wander about. This would appear to be the main square. Nondescript other than that monumental statue. Restaurant front of wood. This old building may be a throwback to the original that gave the place its reputation. And I think this is the church I had aspired to. I think that is supposed to symbolize the rock, perhaps the one that blocked Jesus' access from the cave. A pretty little church. I wonder if the painting in the back on the walls is what remains of what was original. I wonder if these outdoor crosses reflect the same intent as those in Switzerland and Austria, which was to relegate the aboriginals for a couple hundred years to the outside of the church until they were, even though converted, deemed worthy. Here we can see how brickwork can be made pretty by the way it is laid in, layered, indented, and so forth. As is this building that's just about fully restored, it appears. It appears that once there were very important families lived here, reasonably important. They're a rather modern and eclectic design building. Very interesting, particularly for the people who live up on top. Here, an old wooden building, which apparently used to typify much of this and still does in certain neighborhoods. So we'll look for more of it. Not at all atypical for, let's say, the Northwest or Canada even more so. The whole block reflects that kind of more interesting architecture, modern. Here's a pretty, it's either new or well-restored wooden home. Up there, stairs appeared to lead to a park-like area, so we'll explore that. So far, a pretty little pathway through what once was terraced, probably for farming. The trail can go up there, so I think I'll go up further. It appears that all of this was terraced. The side trails to the steep one I'm climbing were those terraced areas. But there's one pinnacle that will go up right over here. Probably a gathering place for various groups, various occasions. The terracing was all on this side. The west sun is setting there. And midday would probably be here. But this all makes sense during the vast time that Lithuania was controlled by the Soviets, the USSR, and the Nazis, not to mention others. Could have provided substantial sustenance for the people hereabout. And I was wrong, not the first time. There's terracing over on this side also. Pretty patch of small blue flowers racing up the slope. The old drinking log, where people can find solitude in both the bottle and the surroundings. Nice area to have near your home if you prize the woods and the exercise of hills. I would say these fungi represent the past of Lithuania, but hopefully not at all its future. These are large. So through there, I exited the forest using a more difficult route than others have found, and to find the river again. So I think I'll track to our left. Going to the other side is a very lovely park. Must be accessed somehow. It's a little spot for couples. Large bird, about the size of a robin, but trimmer. And aggressive enough to keep the crows away from her nest. Pretty bird. Very pretty park across the way. Lovely water feature fountain up to our far right that you can't see from here. Hopefully a bridge that you can't see from here.